Well, good evening, Atomic Church and Facebook Live. Hope you guys are having a great time. I hope you guys are ready to worship and praise Jesus. You know, it's funny because it feels like it's been a long week, but at the same time, it feels like it hasn't. But it's crazy every single day, I tell you what. So just out of the busyness of the week, we just offer this up to all you guys here, watching and here in the building, just to kind of unwind and just really just sit back and just worship God and just relax in His presence. Yeah, we're singing songs and we're playing music, but really we just want to set this time aside to be like, okay, God, I just want more of You. So we're going to go ahead and enter in. Father God, we just lift this time up to You, Lord, and we invite Your presence. We invite Your Spirit. That let this time be all about You, God. That You would arrest us with Your love. That You would take us deeper into You, Father God. That You would bless this time. But we just worship You, for You are so, so good, God. In Jesus' name.
darkness, my God, that is who you are. Even when I don't see it, you work. Even when I don't feel it, you working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you working. Even when I don't feel it, you working. You never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you working. Even when I don't feel it, you working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you working. Even when I don't feel it, you working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Waymaker, miracle worker.
This time of, you know, tribulation that really the whole world is going through, God, we believe that you are the way maker still, and that none of this, you are fazed by none of this, God. And we rest, God, in knowing that you are going to be taking care of us, Lord. No matter what, God, you say that if we call upon you, Lord, and we ask you to save us, God, that you will. That if we believe that you are the Savior, Jesus.
Keeper, light in the go before I know that you've even got to end my world. all I did was worship. All I did was bow down. All I did was stay still.
Before we go into the next song, how many of you, either watching or even in this room, have ever felt lost or have ever felt broken or have ever just had a moment where you looked at yourself in a reflection and went, I don't even know who I am anymore. Like, where is me? Where have I gone? If you've ever been in that moment, you know how real it is and how low it can feel. Bridge broke me way more than I thought it was going to. We've been practicing this song, but for some reason right now, kind of just hit me. So I guess my encouragement is just, if you've ever felt like you were in that place or you're in that place right now, there's hope, there's restoration, there's a God who is constant, there's a God who is jealous for you, and he's jealous for your love and your affection, and he does not see you as broken or unforgivable or too lost. He seeks you out. When I thought I lost me, you know where to found, like, he knew where to found me, right? He picked up all my pieces, put me back together. For those of you who've been in that broken place or are in that broken place, it's a real dark place to be in. But you have a God who is the Savior of the universe, and believe it or not, he sees you, and he loves you, and he fights for you, and he has not forgotten about you, and he will find you. He will put the pieces of yourself and your heart and your identity back together, because your identity is through Jesus Christ. So that's all I'm going to say about that, but I just encourage you guys to know you're not too far gone. You're not forgotten. You're not a mistake. It doesn't matter what you've done. It doesn't matter where you've gone. It doesn't matter what your past or your history has said. Because we have a new future in Jesus Christ. We have a new identity. We have a new name. We can walk in forgiveness and wholeness. Amen.
So I want to tell you guys something, a little story that happened earlier this week about this particular song. I was given the opportunity to figure out some songs that might work for this Sunday service, and I was praying over a whole list of songs, actually, and I couldn't decide between a couple of them. They were really, they're very powerful songs. And I asked Maddie to sing them for me because I knew... Actually, the Holy Spirit told me, as soon as you hear, you'll know which one it is. So she sang one of the songs, and it was like, wow, that was really good. But I didn't feel the feeling. I knew there wasn't something there that needed to be there. So I asked her to sing this song, and about four words into the song, I start bawling hysterically. I had chills all over my body. And if we chose this song just for the sake of that, just for the sake of Alicia having her moment where she needed to be reminded that where she lost her, he found her, or you listening, if that song was that song that made you remember that he picked up all your pieces and put you back together, that was all worth that chill that I got, that moment that I had with the Lord of breaking down hysterical crying, because it brought it to you. And this is an amazing song. So I'm sitting over here on the side with chills just listening and feeling the emotions from Alicia as well. So I hope that blessed you.
Is there any possible way we can, like, get back to that bridge? And just sing that one more time through.
Up all the pieces, put me back together.
Thank you.
Alicia said earlier was, and even Pastor Sarah just kind of both together, was very powerful, and that's that God wants to have those moments with you. He wants to, even if it's for a split second, just really let you know how He feels about you. And that's nothing but love. I think sometimes our view of God, just by either the way we grew up or even just kind of looking at our own earthly fathers, can sometimes get a little obscured, in the sense of sometimes we feel like we have to be perfect when we come before God. We have to do everything right in order to come before Him. We have to say the right words. We have to, you know, just all these different things. But really, God is just like, come to me. The way you are, whatever you're going through, come to me. Because I love you, and I want to have a moment with you. And He wants to let you know how much He really loves you. And it's enough to give up His own life just so He could spend eternity with you. So as we go on through the rest of tonight, because we got a couple more songs, just really take that time, even if it's just taking a pause from singing with us, or, you know, not tuning it out, but just really tuning into God and just being like, okay, God, here I am. What do you want to tell me? What do you want to say to me? He's a good God. He really is a good God.
Go. You have spoken. Jesus,
We love you. God, you are so good. We can't get enough of you, Lord. We will never stop seeking after you, God. We can never get enough. We just thank you, God, for being here with us, for those who are watching. We thank you, God, that you are great, you are powerful, Lord. You are changing lives, that you are impacting hearts, God. Thank you for blessing us and allowing us just to freely worship you here, for allowing us to be able to enter into your presence, God. We thank you. Bless the rest of our weekend, God, and just as we go into our next week, things that we have before us this next week and the rest of this month, we ask you, God, that you'd walk with us, that you'd walk in us and through us, Lord, that you'd use us, the Father God. Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. All right, guys. Well, thank you for joining us here and just watching us and worshiping with us. We're going to be back next week, same time, 7 o'clock. We love you guys.